Alright, welcome back to Project Zanky Redo here. In the last episode, you saw me take the all the front lighting out, fenders off, wheels, tires, rear subframe out, plus the rear fuel tank. That was to do the undercoating. I've let it dry and cure. Took it about 3 days to do that, to cure in the 70 degree temperature. Now, as you see behind me, I'm starting to put it back together. Piece by piece, it's going in just as it came out. I've also taken the time to now polish the headlights. And this is just simply done with a 2000 grit sandpaper, sand it down. And I've also got a bottle of the Meguiar's Plastex. And this is just do this, apply it with a terry cloth applicator, apply it down, buff it, and then take it off before it dries. And that will give you a better finish here. You can see it's a lot less yellow compared to the past. Now it's more of a clear white again. More on. Put it back together.
All right, welcome back. As you can see, the front end of the car is completely put together. I did actually do a little bit of vinyl work right on the bottom just to cover up that crossbar. It always bugged me that it was red, so I did do that. You can see the headlights, they're a little bit brighter. I did polish those up a little bit more. That way they don't have kind of a yellow tinge anymore. They're closer to the clear of the corner markers there. Now I have moved back onto the rear end of the car. As you can see here, it's currently in a big mess. I'm doing the subframe mounts first and then kind of doing the differential at the same time as the subframes goes. The subframe mounts are pretty easy to come out. I think everybody does the burning method, which it does work. I like to take a cordless drill here. I do have about a quarter inch drive or quarter inch size drill bit. And I drill holes down around the mount itself. And then once you do that, you can take your torch. I just use small, like a little Burns-O-Matic there, the little fat boy, and actually burn it there. And that's going to take the rubber once it's burned, and then it's going to take it and harden it so that it will come out a lot easier. Once you do that a few times, you can actually take a mallet and burn it out. And I just use a three pound sledgehammer, pound out the center, take the middle of it out, and then just continue to burn it. Once you get to the bottom here, I actually do have a cordless drill, and you can see it just a wire brush on the side, and that's actually going to clean up the material enough that you can actually put it in. So right now I do have the two rear subframe mounts in. You can see them there. I actually do have the third one in. I just don't have the centerpiece in. And here's what the fourth one is looking like. Now it is already burned out, and as you can see, it still is left with rubber inside. And I still have to clean that out with wire brush. Once that's cleaned, you add in some grease and then put your mount in. And then the subframe is ready to go back in when you're ready. I'm also doing the differential bushings here. As you can kind of see, differential has dropped out. I'm actually currently working on taking those rears out. And then from there, I'm going to take the ISIS rear suspension arms and put those in. So that's it for now. Back to work. Okay, now you can see that I do have the mount completely done. Have it all wire brushed out, and now I do actually have some grease in there. So now it's a matter of just putting the mount in, pressing it in with my hand, and you can also use a mallet or something else, you know, just to give it a little extra finesse. As you notice, this does make a huge mess to do this, so make sure you do have the opportunity to clean up eventually. And now I'm going to move on to the differential. Okay, as you can see here, I do have the differential pushed out. I do have the center cup on the passenger side out now. So I'm just letting it burn. That way it vulcanizes the rubber and it turns it hard, and that makes it look very brittle. Comes out very easy. So I'm just gonna give it a little bit more time to burn. And then I'm gonna work on the other side and then I'll clean it up with a wire brush. Get it ready for the new bushings. Okay, now once you have the differential mounts back in, the subframe in, the subframe is ready to go in. As you can see, I already have mine put in. It's just a matter of putting it with the floor jack, keeping it level, and raising it up to the car. Once there, it's just a matter of getting the A-brackets put on. You can see there on the bottom in the red, and there's the mounts with the subframe attached. That's all for this time. We'll see you next time.